Okay, so what colors do you like?
Blue up there.
Yeah, any other ones you like?
I want gun, blue, green, and blue.
Blue, green, and blue. Blue, green, and blue?
Blue and green.
Blue and green. Anything else?
This and this and this.
Okay. Thank you. Love you.
I don't like lots of them. That.
You don't like those ones, do you?
I like that one.
You like the blue and the green?
Yes.
Okay. Hi everyone. So for this makeup tutorial, I decided to let my baby Robbie decide what makeup I should have. And I'm using the TTD eye contact lens in the color Egypt Purple, and it took me a couple of tries, as you can see. And you just gotta keep on persisting if you're a first timer for putting in contact lenses. This isn't my first time, but this is kind of my first time putting it in myself. But of course, number 10 was the perfect 10. So I started off with my e.l.f. Cosmetics Poreless Putty Primer, and all you have to do is apply a tiny bead of it into your hand and rub it together, and then apply it mostly on your T-zone. Then, because I had a few blemishes, I went ahead with my e.l.f. 16 Camo Concealer in the shade of medium beige and just applied a few dabs on those blemishes. Which is pretty much my whole face, to be honest. Then once you've done that, grab a damp beauty blender and just kind of buff it out a little bit. Then I went ahead with my Revolution Conceal and Define Coverage Foundation in the color F5, and this has a large applicator, but I also went over this with my damp beauty blender. Please don't forget to blend down your neck. Next, I'm going in with the concealer in a lighter color, the color Light Peach. And like I said in my last video, I needed a lighter shade, but this is way light, so I'll have to look for another shade that will hopefully be my shade. But I'm just blending this again with a beauty blender just for a highlight. Next, I'm going over with my NYX Cream Highlight and Contour Palette, and I'm just using my contour brush to put in some color into my cheekbones and put a bit more color into my face and get rid of all that whiteness from the concealer. And I'm also making a nose line. Then I went over with my NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat Setting Powder in the color Cream Natural, and I'm just applying this pretty much everywhere, but mostly condense it to where I applied the concealer earlier. Next, onto our brows, the most important part. I'm using my Maybelline Tattoo Brow Brow Pomade in the color Dark Brown, and as you can see, I've been using this a lot, but I like to brush up my brows first and just kind of follow the natural shape of my brows. And my technique is to make like an angry face and try and match it up that way, because pretty much 90% of the time it will equal into even brows. But then I go over with my concealer and just kind of clean up around my brows for all the imperfections that have happened. So this is my first baby. This is my first ever eyeshadow palette. I bought it from Gaisano Mall probably 7 years ago, and this was for 75 pesos, so I pretty much saved up for it. But as chosen by Robert, he chose blue and green, so I'm going to use them. Starting off with the blue, I'm just applying it into the outer corner and pretty much blending it halfway over my lid. And then going into the green, I just kind of mixed it in, but into the inner part, and also blending it upwards towards my brow. Then I went in with a black eyeliner and just kind of made a wing and applied a little tiny bit underneath my eyes, which I then blended out, made like a smoky effect with a lot denser brush. Then I went ahead and used the green shade under my eyes because it needed a little bit of love. Then I applied this light shade of blue and just applied it into the inner part of my eye. An important step before you apply anything onto your eyelashes is to always curl your lashes. For my mascara, I'm using the Essence that What a Fake Lengthening and Volumizing Mascara. I love this. Then going in with my lashes, I'm running out of them. Something different, I wanted to apply loose glitter, so I used the e.l.f. glitter glue and just applied it pretty much everywhere. Transition time. For my bronzer, I use the Tarte Tardiest Pro Glow To Go palette, and I'm just using the bronzer in that palette. And for my first ever blush, which I still have, which was for 29 pesos, as you can see, it is an orange shade, but I love it because it gives like a natural hue, and it did come with that tiny brush. But just look at its pigment, it is so pigmented, which is pretty much why I still have it, even though it's probably expired, which you should never keep expired makeup. Then I'm going in with this little palette, the I Love Revolution Chocolate Elixir Glow Highlighter Kit. It comes with two highlighter shades, but I'm going to use that lighter shade of highlighter. Whenever I'm coming up with a makeup look, it's really hard for me to find out what lipstick shade I want to use, but I'm going in with my Mellow Cosmetics lipstick in the color Posh, which I'll have a link down for you guys, but I love this color because it's natural. And then going into another early lipstick that I have from Miss Rose in the color Viper, and I'm just making an ombre look with my lips, so just applying a tiny bit of it into the middle of my lips. And not forgetting to set my face with the Tarte Stay Spray, just to make my makeup stay a little bit longer. So this is a makeup look that I come up with. The colors that my son chose for me from my first ever eyeshadow palette. It's always fun to have a little bit of fun, but always remember that once your makeup is expired, please throw it out, even though I didn't throw mine out. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe if you haven't already, and comment down below if you want to ask any questions or just want to say hello. I felt that I had so much fun and I'm just stepping backwards in the video. Bye guys. Too perfect, you don't need no filter. Gorgeous, make them drop dead. You a killer. Shower you with